This video will show you how to get on a Google Meet during a synchronous e-learning day. If you are in grades 6 through 12, navigate to your Canvas course and select the Google Meet link provided by your teacher for your class period. If you are in grades kindergarten through 5th grade, navigate to your class's activities on Seesaw, locate your agenda, tap Start, and tap the Google Meet link icon to join your class's Google Meet at 8:15. Keep in mind that all students in grades 6 through 12 will have a different Google Meet link to attend throughout the day, so return to Canvas to get those links. Elementary students will remain on the same Google Meet all day. Tapping on a Google Meet link will open the Google Meet window. Tap Continue. Tap Allow on all pop-ups that might appear on your screen. Before you join the first time, you can adjust your background by tapping on this portrait icon. Scroll down along the right side to view the different choices for a background. Tapping on one will replace your current background with the background you chose. Once you have selected a background, tap the X to return to the Google Meet screen. Tap the Join button in the bottom right-hand corner to join the meet. If you are early to the meet, you may see the message waiting for the host to join. This means your teacher has not joined yet and you need to wait for your teacher. While we wait, let's look at the icons at the bottom. The red circle with the telephone will end the Google Meet. The circle with the video camera will turn the camera on and off. Your teacher may want you to keep your camera on. The microphone icon will mute and unmute your microphone. You will want to keep your microphone muted until you need to speak. Once your teacher has joined the meet, you will see your teacher and classmates begin to appear. Notice the Google Meet icons are missing. Tap your iPad screen and the Google Meet tools will reappear. Remember, tapping on the camera icon will turn the camera off and on. Tapping on the microphone icon will mute or unmute the microphone. Let's look at some more options. Tap the three dots. In Call Messages will open the chat window where you can type a question or response for your teacher or classmates to see. You might type, "I have a question," and the teacher may respond, "What is your question?" You can also signal to your teacher that you have a question by raising your hand. Tap the icon with the hand to raise your hand or to put your hand down. Your teacher may want you to share your work with everyone. Tap the three dots and tap Share Screen. You will want to check the box if what you're sharing will have audio that others in the Google Meet will need to hear. Then tap Continue. Next, tap Start Broadcast, and then you will see a countdown. 3, 2, 1. Navigate away from the Google Meet screen and select what it is you should be presenting to your class, such as a project you did in the Pages app. If you are presenting something with sound, your classmates and teacher in the meet will hear the sound because you checked the box earlier. To stop sharing your screen, tap the Google Meet window in the top right corner to get back to the Google Meet screen. Then choose Stop Sharing at the top. You will see the message with your name stopped sharing their screen at the bottom. The next pop-up confirms that you have stopped sharing. Press OK. Another option in Google Meet is to turn on captions. With captions on, when someone starts speaking in a Google Meet, you will see their words at the bottom of the Google Meet screen. Tap the three dots to hide the captions. Tapping the red circle will end the Google Meet. If you ended the Google Meet by mistake, tap Rejoin, then Join to be returned to the meet. The meet will close when your teacher ends the meet. You will not be able to re-enter. Remember, you will have different links for Google Meets throughout the day, so always refer back to Canvas or Seesaw for the links provided by your teacher.